I'm not the biggest fan of Ariana Grande's music, but some of my subscribers kept telling me that there was more than meets the eye, and so I set a challenge for myself to find her best written songs ever. I picked 16, and then I narrowed that down to the 7 best, and here they are. Hey everybody, I'm Clifford Stumpy, the Pop Song Professor, and welcome to my channel where we make English class awesome by explaining and sometimes ranking song lyrics on school days. And today, we are talking about Ariana Grande's 7 best written songs. First off, when you're done watching this, I've also linked below Taylor Swift's 7 best and 7 worst written lyrics as well, in case you're interested. The answers may surprise you. I've also put links in at the end of the video, and you can click on them there. And now, for honorable mentions. These first two that are honorable mentions were my favorite songs that Ariana Grande made an appearance on, but it didn't feel fair to pick them as among the 7 best because she wasn't the reason I liked them. Number one was Break Your Heart Right Back with Childish Gambino, where he raps, "Listen, you got a man, but your man ain't loyal. Don't understand how to spell it out for you. Yes, I'm a G from the A, and they ask why. Sorry, I had to tell you I'm a nice guy." And that's just some insanely clever lyric writing. The second was the song Popular with Mika, where they sing together, "You were the popular one, the popular chick. It is what it is, now I'm popular-ish. Standing on the field with your pretty pom-poms, now you're working at the movies selling popular corn." The whole song is very lighthearted and really fun with some cleverness mixed in. Other honorable mentions of just Ariana Grande included Best Mistake, One Last Time, Better Left Unsaid, Better Off, Pete Davidson, Ghostin', and No Tears Left to Cry. These songs, compared to the rest, I felt like either had something to say, said something well, were mildly interesting, but they weren't the best. And now we get to the list. As far as judging goes, I was looking for competent handling of complicated topics with quality and relatable lyrics. The music is important too, but for this video, we're mostly focusing on the lyrics. And so, without further ado, I give you number 7. And number 7 is Moonlight from Dangerous Woman. In it, she sings, I never knew, you could hold moonlight in your hands till the night I held you, you are my moonlight, moonlight." Really, the reason I picked this one was because I really liked that central metaphor or image. The song overall, I felt, was very good at describing things, and it kind of helped you to feel like you were there. It helped you to feel her song more than you're able to feel most of her songs, which tend to be a little bit more on the vague side. Number 6 is the song Piano by Yours Truly, largely for the interesting topic, but also for what I thought were some decently well put together lyrics. She sings, "I could write a song with my new piano. I could sing about how love is a losing battle, but I'd rather make a song that can play on the radio that makes you want to dance," which kind of felt like not quite a commentary on her career, but it definitely felt self-aware. She's constantly making songs that either make people want to dance or that are about love as a losing battle, but to hear her kind of describe the process and be a little bit self-aware for a second, even if it's not her writing the lyrics, I really appreciated that. Number 5, You Don't Know Me from her album My Everything. Here she sings, "The girl you see in photographs is only a part of the one I am. Don't judge me because that's not reality, and all I can be is in love with who I'm becoming." I think sometimes she gets a little bit too mushy with all the self-love stuff, but I thought that this song was, again, kind of self-aware, and I'm really looking for self-aware music from Ariana Grande. Songs where it feels like somebody would have had to have said, "Hey, lyric writers, I want to talk about this," or where even maybe Ariana had to pen some of the lyrics herself. And so it was great for her to be able to talk about how she wasn't quite the public image that she was perceived as. I can appreciate that. This sounds like a real struggle for a celebrity, and it was good to hear something that was a struggle for Ariana rather than something that maybe she or lyric writers felt like we as her audience could empathize with. You know, just some classic trash love / breakup song. Number 4 is from her album Thank You Next, and it's her song In My Head. Take a listen to these. "Wanted you to grow, but boy, you wasn't budding. Everything you are made you everything you aren't. I saw your potential without seeing credentials. Maybe that's the issue." Said maybe that's the issue. "Can't hold that shit against you. Guess I did it to myself. Thought you were somebody else." Now, these lines and the song in particular are interesting on a couple of levels. Number one, she is talking about something that was in her head. So again, we get to see a topic that's a little bit more cerebral, handled with a little bit more intentionality rather than just throwing a bunch of cliches in there, even though there are a handful of cliches in the song. But I really like this concept of how she's not only admitting fault herself, so she's saying, "Yeah, I made a mistake," and it's not just like a classic, "It's not me, It's You Breakup Song, but also she's getting more in depth in the analysis of the relationship. I love this line. I saw your potential without seeing credentials. And I think that's a line that a lot of our audience could probably benefit from, that a lot of us could benefit from. And so overall, the song is a good example of holding somebody else in a relationship to a high standard, but also holding yourself to a high standard and not just letting yourself jump into every relationship willy-nilly without some proof that it will work. If you guys are enjoying these lyrics, or you're thinking that you want to write better lyrics than these, or you'd like to be able to write lyrics this good, be sure to check out the magical songwriting process in the description down below. It's a quick, easy sign up, and you'll get a 9-step process where I explain to you exactly how to write really strong song lyrics. But anyway, to number 3, Fake Smile, also from Thank You Next. I was really surprised with how many songs showed up from Thank You Next. Which I think is maybe indicative of what I've seen a lot of songwriters do, where they have realized that being personal actually appeals to fans, and so they've started to do it more. But anyway, in Fake Smile, she sings, "I read the things they write about me. Hear what they're saying on the TV, it's crazy. It's getting hard for them to shock me, but every now and then it's shocking, don't blame me. I know it's the life that I chose, but baby, I'm grateful. I want you to know I'm happy for the love and all of the above. If I'm being honest, I done been through way too much." This is another one of her talking about her experience with her relationship, with how people view her. And I think you've got some really healthy, positive vibes coming from this. But we also have some really honest vibes. Lines like, "But every now and then it's shocking, and I know it's the life that I chose." And so she knows that, like, she's saying she knew what she was getting into, but it's still kind of difficult. And that just feels more honest and vulnerable than I think I've really heard from Ariana ever. Now, to be fair, I don't really know what crazy things people are saying about her. Like, right now, it feels like people are only saying good and positive things about her, but I'm probably missing stuff. Because I don't follow celebrity gossip, and neither should you. Live your life, people. Number 2 is Thank You Next, from Thank You Next. This one was super personal, and it felt like, oh my gosh, this is like one of the first times where I almost could give Ariana Grande the entire benefit and say, like, wow, I wouldn't be surprised if she wrote some of these lyrics completely by herself. Listen to this. "Thought I'd end up with Sean, but he wasn't a match. Wrote some songs about Ricky, now I listen and laugh. Even almost got married, and for Pete, I'm so thankful. Wish I could say thank you to Malcolm, cause he was an angel." Mentioning 4 ex-boyfriends, talking a little bit about what she learned from them, especially as she gets into the chorus and the verse. And it's really interesting to kind of hear this perspective, and we can kind of hear about the life lived by somebody who, yeah, maybe we've seen some tabloid articles about them or seen something show up on our Twitter feed, and now it's like she's actually commenting on it. And so it's really interesting because it feels honest, it feels vulnerable, and those are probably the 2 most important things to actually good songwriting. Of course, the rhyming and the construction of them are really well done, the rhythm's good, all the stuff, blah, 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 but we didn't need to say that with Ariana Grande. Like, she's good at making lyrics look good, but now it also feels like, wow, she wrote a song that makes me feel like I get to know Ariana Grande a little bit. Finally, number 1, top best song by Ariana Grande that I could find, all right, out of all of the ones from her main albums, she released this song, Get Well Soon, from Sweetener. Now, I wasn't looking for her best song to come from Sweetener. A lot of times a pop artist's best songs are from their earlier albums before they became so mainstream, or in the case of Ariana Grande, where her last album has started to get more personal. But here we are, Sweetener, Get Well Soon. She sings, "Want you to get better. My life is so controlled by the what ifs. Is there anybody else whose mind does this? Is there such a ladder to get above this? Maybe I should ground myself where the mud is before I'm gone." And in a tweet to a fan, she actually said that this song was about a time where she was feeling super removed from herself, was struggling with some sort of mental issues, and it felt like, again, wow, she's getting a little bit real and honest here. And instead of trying to write something that would immediately be applicable to everybody's situation, love and breakup for the most part, she says, "Is there anybody else whose mind does this? My life is so controlled by the what ifs." Now, it's probably an easy answer that yes, a lot of people's lives are controlled by the what ifs, but to hear that a pop star's life is controlled by the what ifs, I think it's a powerful way to tell her own story. And I think that's the thing that I saw in these 7 lyrics that we've looked at, is that it seemed that these were the times that Ariana Grande not only got vulnerable and honest, but it's when she started to tell her own story. Instead of trying to tell our story and how, you know, she thinks that we live, and so we can connect somehow and sing along with her songs, but it felt like, okay, I get to listen to her songs and I get to connect to the real parts, and then I get to also observe the parts that are real but don't connect to me naturally. And I thought that was pretty cool. If you guys want to check out Taylor Swift's 7 best lyrics, click here. If you want to check out her 7 worst written songs, click here. And I will be posting a 7 worst Ariana Grande written songs sometime soon. Talk to you guys later.